While it's great that we can query our database through the content provider, it would be nice if we could also use the content provider to put data in. We'll begin with the insert function. Let's fill the insert function with the same URI matcher code we have in the other content provider functions, but with one change. We're only going to match the base URIs. There's a good reason for this. When we insert into our database, we wanted to notify every content observer that might have data modified by our insert. It turns out that cursors register themselves as notify for descendants, which means that notifying the root URI will also notify all descendants of that URI. If we were to notify based on anything else other than the root URI, then a cursor listening on the root URI will not get notified of a change that would certainly impact it. So we have to be very careful when doing that. For this reason, it makes a lot of sense to only allow insertions at our root URI into our database. That way, it's very, very easy to handle notifications. It means that we also don't have to build a combination query for our insert, containing a parameter coming from the URI, with the rest of the parameters coming from a function. So for weather, we just pass the parameters into a database insert call. We should throw an exception if the insert fails. The only trick here is to make sure we return the correct value, which is a URI. Fortunately, we made a function to build these URIs, which contain the weather path followed by an ID. Let's go test this. Once again, we go to test provider, and we modify our test. Because after all, it's supposed to be test insert read provider. Here's our insert statement. Obviously, it's still talking to the database. We're going to want to make it talk to the provider. As always, that's pretty straightforward. We always get our provider by using our content resolver. So we can replace this insert statement with the DB with a content resolver instead. And of course, we don't use a content resolver against a table name. Instead, we do it against the weather entry .contenturi. But there's still something wrong. Of course, we don't actually return the weather row ID. We return a URI. But we can still get a weather row ID. How do we do that? Quite simply, using a helper function in content URIs. And we don't really need that insert. After all, we know that this content resolver function isn't actually going to return unless the value is true. Now that we've finished that, let's run the test and make sure that we can actually insert using our content provider. And our tests pass. Well, you know what time it is. Time for you to write some of this as well.